Hi, welcome back to Maria's Kitchen. I'm so excited to be here to share this wonderful recipe with you. We are in California here and we are in the hundreds, so I'm devising some cool recipes for you. And today I have a sesame Asian salad with shredded chicken, and it's going to be delicious and it'll be put together in a matter of minutes. So stay tuned, I'll be right back to go over the ingredients. These three things are optional: mandarin oranges. And then we've got two corn tortillas that I fried up and cut up and fried. And then we've got sesame seeds for the top. So we're going to go right over here and get started with what you'll need. You'll need cabbage. You will need chicken. And I boiled this chicken, and there'll be a link on the screen. You need carrots, shredded carrots, and cut up green scallions. One garlic clove minced very small. You'll need red bell peppers sliced. You'll need a purple onion sliced. Two celery stalks sliced. You'll need, I have two choices here. You can have a ground ginger or cut up your own ginger here. You'll need, oh, my favorite, crushed red pepper. And then two tablespoons of just regular peanut butter. And then we've got the rice vinegar, the soy sauce, toasted sesame oil. And you have a choice. You can use agave or honey or one tablespoon of sugar, salt and pepper, and I think that's it. And we'll get back to get started. So we're going to make the dressing for the salad. You're going to need to put a fourth cup of the rice vinegar. You're going to need a fourth cup of the soy sauce. And you're going to need one heaping teaspoon of ginger. And I'm using the ground one, but you can grind yours up. The next thing we're going to use is one teaspoon of the sesame oil. And then we're putting the two tablespoons of peanut butter. I'm going to try to get all that in there, all of it, so it'll taste really, really good. And we're going to mix this up. You're going to need one. I've got one big teaspoon, or it's about a teaspoon, of the garlic minced very small. We're going to put one tablespoon of sugar. We're going to mix this up, and my favorite ingredient, you don't have to do this, but it's just a little few dashes of the crushed chili peppers. And now you're going to mix this up very well. This is the dressing here, all mixed up very well. And you just set it aside while you chop all of your vegetables. And so this is ready. So the very first thing we're going to do is, since we have our dressing done, we're going to get it all into this big bowl, and we are going to submerge the chicken, put all the chicken in there. And this is 2 cups of shredded chicken, and we're going to kind of toss it till it all gets covered with this dressing, and then we'll be back to put the salad together. So here's the chicken, and it's got all the dressing. You're going to put 2 cups of shredded cabbage, and I have green cabbage. You're going to put the 3/4 cup to 1 cup of shredded carrots, 2 celery stalks I have sliced here, and I have 1 cup of sliced red bell peppers. Ooh, I love those. I have the purple onion here, 1 cup sliced. Ooh! And then I have the scallions, 1/8 cup. Putting that in. We're putting our pepper in, and we're putting our salt in, 1/2 teaspoon each. So I'm actually going to put the gloves on, and I'm going to come back and I'm going to toss this. We are ready to toss, and I got my kitchen gloves on, because I want to make sure I get it really good. We're just going to mix everything, bring the chicken up from the bottom with the dressing. Look how pretty this looks. This wasn't that hard. Look at, we didn't turn the oven on. Look at these vibrant, beautiful colors. Oh, they're so pretty. And you know what? You could play with this. You can add more of something that you like. Maybe you want more red bell pepper. Maybe you want more onions. I mean, you could just play with this, but this is just a recipe that I have. Oh, look how beautiful. Look at this. I can't wait to try it. It's so cool. And we will be back to put it in a pretty dish and garnish it. So I had an idea. I wanted a crunchy topping and I had corn tortillas. So I cut these up and there's going to be a video. So the video how to do this is going to start right now and I'll be back to garnish this beautiful salad. Okay, you're going to need two corn tortillas and you're just going to start slicing them with a knife. I'd say about a quarter inch thick. And this is going to be for the crunchy topping on the salad. But you can also, I'm going to go across this way, maybe in about an inch and a half strips, inch and a half, and then over here. And we are going to fry them up. So have a pan on. I put about 2 tablespoons of oil, vegetable oil, and it's on a medium high. We're going to slide all of these into the pan. And we're gonna start frying them. Now you're gonna have to stay right next to them and maybe even lower your flame a little because we need to get them crunchy but not burned. So you're gonna wanna move them around quickly and let them fry on one side, then we'll turn them over. Okay, they're coming along nicely. Now I think that the best thing to use is tongs. That way you can separate them and turn them over so that each side gets crispy, and then you can separate them and move them around. I think the tongs is really good to use for this. Just keep moving them, tossing them around till they're kind of all browned a little evenly on each side, and I'll be back to show you the finished product. At this point, the salad is actually done, but I want to show you three little garnishes that you can put on top. So this is how I like to do it. I like to put a couple of beautiful little oranges around the side and just to decorate it, just throw them, I don't know, around the side, however you want to decorate it, but I'm just throwing a couple around the side. Give it a little color, and I love these, so I put a couple around the edges, and then I've got the crunchy little toppings here, and you can put some on there, and then we're going to sprinkle it with some sesame seeds all over the top, and you are done here, and it looks beautiful, and this you can take to anywhere. I am so excited. We are at the finale of the show, and now it's the time where I'm going to try this. And it is so cool and refreshing. Here it goes. I think it has enough dressing, but I'm actually going to put a few dots more. Some people don't like a lot of dressing. That's why I made an extra one on the side so that if people want more, they can put more on top. So you might want to make a double batch of the dressing and stir it very well because the peanut butter has to mix. This is so good. I love the little crunch with the fried corn tortillas. And you don't have to do that, but I like it a lot. It gives it a really nice crunch. I am going to put this down and I'm going to stop eating for now. I will be back with the scripture of the day, but I just want to give you a little heads up that I'll be doing a midweek show and showing you how to make this wonderful Mexican horchata. The scripture of the day that I chose was Matthew 5:16. Let your light shine, let it so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let the light of Christ that lives in you shine through your work, your smile, your graciousness, your kindness, and all your good works. Make sure that you shine for Jesus. It may just be a simple smile. I have to stop to tell you something. I was at the beach and we are supposed to be doing our distancing, but you know what? Children don't understand everything that's going on. And I was at the beach and this little girl with her mask on, she was so adorable. And she said, "Hi," she yells from the farthest part of the beach, "Hi, hi," and she was just smiling and it just filled me with so much joy. And I just smiled back and I said, "Hi," and I just waved to her. I mean, just those little simple things we can do to cheer someone up. Smile, be kind, let your light shine. And I will be right back. I've got something to tell you that's super exciting, and thank you for spending time with me on the show today. I just want to stop to give everybody thanks. All of my subscribers, I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. We have reached over 700 and it is climbing fast daily. And so how appropriate it would be to celebrate. And I've got two people here to pop some poppers.
4th of July.
4th of July, it works perfect. Go ahead. We got one more? No? Okay. Thank you so much for spending time with me. Have a happy 4th of July with your family and friends. And make sure you keep your distance, but smile. Have a good time.